Hey guys, I'm back as promised with my review for Kevin Ross's Audacity Volume 2. So let's get into this review. So overall, I really like this album. I'm not sure if he's classifying as an EP because it is 7 songs with like 2 interludes throughout the song, so I'm not sure of what he's classifying as. But the project overall is very cohesive, which is what I believe a project should sound like. It's very cohesive. Kevin's really in his pocket when it comes to lyrical content. Everything, like I said, is very cohesive. The production is, while there's some interesting things that is being done, he still stays in the lane. He still stays in his kind of crooner lane. Kevin Ross is, at least in my opinion, he's more of a crooner than anything. He can give you some intricate belts and stuff like that, but he really focuses on making sure the lyrics are clear and you can really hear what he's trying to convey through the song. Production wise, I like the use of the reverb, delay, then some of the breakdowns that were added, some of the little I said ad-libs before. So when it comes to that, and the vocal performance, I think it's a really good project, especially if you like are an R&B head like I am. It's a really smooth listen. You can really just listen to it straight through. You could like clean the house with it, use it to get ready, use it to study and stuff like that. So overall, that's my overall thoughts of the EP. So now I'm gonna get directly into specific songs. So I'm gonna start off with the first song of the album, which is called "God Is a Genius." So, let me give you 1 second. Let me put this up here. So, what we have here is "God Is a Genius." As I was talking about before, what I appreciate about this track is that it's very light on production. There's not a whole bunch of overused reverb and delay on his vocal. It's pretty natural, and he's predominantly in the center, and the instruments are pretty much just embellishing what he's already producing vocally. So you have the light guitar and the light bass in the background, and with the light drums. It sounds like they're predominantly on like the on the snare drums, predominantly, and then some cymbals added with the drum set, with the drum kit. So it's pretty light. Then you have his ad-libs throughout the song, which predominantly you're just using slight reverb and slight delay. So the next song on the track list is "I Do" / "Options." It's a 2-part song. The first part is "I Do." Again, what I said before still rings true with this song. The production is very light. When it comes to instrumentation, predominantly what you're hearing is a lot of hi-hat. The kick is primarily keeping the beat for the song. Especially for "I Do." Again, he's very in center. He's in his vocal pocket. Sounds like he's more of in his mid range, which is seems to be the most comfortable part of his voice. I really appreciate the 2-part because it gives different sides of what Kevin can do. This is more on the softer, slower side, and then "Options" gives you like a differentiation of it. It's a lot I wouldn't say it's a lot faster, but it's faster than what he usually does, even though I do is kind of fast in itself. It's more mid-tempo than anything else. So overall, this song is a good song. I like the, like I said, I like the differentiation of each song. So the next song we have right now is called Remind You. So what I really like about this song is how they have the mic placement. So the mic placement is primarily, when speaking about the guitar, it's right next to the guitar, so you can really hear the strings of the guitar. So I'm not sure where they place the mic, but it sounds like they put it like directly where the I feel, is it the bell of the guitar, where the string, like where the opening of the guitar is, so you can really hear that string, the strings right there, and then some of the light sounds that they added to the production. Again, this is a, while this is a shorter song, it kind of sticks straight to the point, which is why I like it. Straight to the point, and it kind of fits. It fits kind of the ending of Options, and goes straight into Remind You. And you can see this continued theme throughout the album, where the songs pretty much lead into each other, which is why, when I said before I started breaking down the songs individually, I live for the cohesion of the project, because sometimes projects don't, like, there'll be songs, but they don't always lead into the next song. It kind of is an abrupt shift to a new song. So I appreciate that it's not as abrupt, and it kind of flows into the next song. That's pretty much what I love about the song vocally. He's in his pocket again. So that's my thoughts on Remind You. So the next song we have is Overthinking. Overthinking, pretty much, as I said before, like the last track, with Remind You, it's pretty much going cohesively to the next song. So this is really kind of ending the idea of what Remind You was presenting, which I really appreciate. So you're pretty much hearing what the foundation of this track is, pretty much his vocals. So which I like. So the only added instrument really is like a slight kick throughout the song, but primarily it's focused on his voice and the idea of overthinking. So I really appreciate the track for that, because it kind of, while most of this is pretty mid-tempo, most of the project is mid-tempo, it kind of slows it down a little bit until you get into the next track going forward. So that's my thoughts about this track. So yeah, let's go into the next one. So now we have one of my favorite tracks of this whole project, which is Everybody Here Wants You. This is Kevin featuring a newer artist I'm not familiar with, but I really love what she contributed. Her name is Kanjalag. If this pretty much is just a duet, a true collaboration. Production is pretty simple, minimal. Again, the vocals are pretty natural throughout. You might have a little reverb and delay, specifically on the backgrounds, but I like how they're mirrored, specifically when they start singing together in the chorus. After they both go, you can kind of hear how how their voices complement each other. So I really appreciate that. When speaking of Kanjalag, how she's performing the vocal, she really reminds me of like a younger Maya. So I really like she has her own like unique pronunciation, but it really gives me like a really young Maya when she first came out. So and then I also like the back and forth lyrically between them. So that's everybody here wants you. So let's get on to the next track and the next two tracks. So the next two songs, the next two songs are "Pray for Me," which is an interlude, and "Salvation." So I'm gonna talk about them both in the same at the same time because the interlude is very short. But with "Pray for Me," what I do like, it's him having his speaking parts, then the backgrounds are pretty much him vocalizing and ad-libbing throughout. But I also like some of the pen strokes of him writing down songs, and then ruffling up the paper, and then throwing it over because he's trying to make a find a better idea for the song he's trying to create, which is very relatable for creatives. You have an idea, and then you kind of scrap it because you don't think it's good enough, so you keep scrapping and scrapping until you figure out which idea would fit better for what you're trying to convey. And then it goes into the last song of the project, which is "Salvation." So again, we're pretty much we're done with the project. So this is a continuation of what he was talking about in lyrically in "Pray for Me." So again, the production is very minuscule. It's a lot of guitar and keyboard. There's like a few licks. It's very focused on what he's trying to convey. And this song, you hear him using more of his falsetto than any other part of this project. So it's a nice change for the last track. So that's pretty much how I feel. So I'm gonna in the next part and last part of this, I'm just gonna break down some of my favorite lyrics from each song. So I'm getting into some of my favorite lyrics. So going back to the first track, when it comes to the pre-chorus, I'm post in post I'm going to be putting all the lyrics down here so you guys can see what I'm talking about. So the pre-chorus says, "Know that Rome wasn't built in a day. With your feelings you can't be afraid. You know that fear only gets in the way. It's not complicated. What I'm trying to say is," and it directly leads into the chorus, "God must be a genius, or me and you wouldn't be here. I know that this was heaven sent. I don't believe in coincidence." So lyrically, I like how cohesive it goes into the chorus, and just the fact of just concise lyrics using imagery, which I really appreciate from Kevin when it comes to his writing. So getting on to the next song. So when it comes to "I Do" and "Options," so let me see some in a second. So when it comes to the first verse, it says, "You say you're through with love, but I'm trying to see who broke your faith yet. And to try again, try again, try again, try again." Okay, so you say you're through with love, but I'm trying to see who broke your faith, yeah. "And to try again will take too much energy. You spent all your time and it ain't meant to be. No need to rush, we can take it slow. Go at your own pace. Guarding your heart too defensively can turn a future lover into enemies." I really like that line because this happens a lot. Some people get hurt in relationships or just in friendships, period. And even with your own family, you kind of lose the belief that love is real sometimes, and you can actually turn to people that actually in your head you can feel this way, and it could kind of ruin the relationship you have with the people that actually do care about you, so you'll make them enemies even though they're actually trying to take care of you. So I really appreciate that line for that. And then getting into when it comes to options, the effect of the verse where he's saying throwing fits in Barney's like a toddler, diamonds dripping off you like a faucet, whipping every week new, bottoms on her feet like ragu, buy you Louis, buy you Dolce and Gabbana, just keep that cool bussin' till mañana. Bad as hell, and yeah, you got the juice. That's why you ain't never get gem and looks, 'cause you know that. Oh, you got options. So, yeah. So when it comes to remind you, my favorite lyric, well, favorite few lyrics, it was from the pre-chorus, so I'm sorry that I ain't the type to tell you what you want to hear. No. So when I get close, you can't keep running from me out of fear. No. Then it goes into, straight into the chorus. I'm here to remind you when I'm out of sight that can't nobody love you, girl, you know, like I can. I'm here to remind you when we fuss and fight that you can come and go, but you'll always be mine. I'm here to remind you. You, yeah. So primarily, it's pretty much saying it's pretty straightforward. Again, he's very straightforward and concise with what he's trying to say. But I really like the lyric, especially for the pre-chorus, because sometimes in relationships we don't actually want to hear the truth. Sometimes we want to actually be lied to because we want our ego stroked sometimes. And then when you meet somebody that cares about you and they actually are honest with you, sometimes we can't take it in the most positive ways. So that's what I like about that lyric, kind of because it's very real. Going into overthinking, so being somebody that overthinks a lot, I felt very seen with this. So going to the chorus, let me see soon. So it says the verse specifically. So I'm always in my head about something. Am I doing too much? Am I doing enough? Am I there for the people I care about? Are they there for me when I need them? It's like building a roller coaster. When it's too high, go low. Too fast, move slow. Just don't stand still. But in the stillness, you get to take a closer look at where you've been, where you are, where you're at, and where you want to go. You know you can conquer the mind, you conquer, you know you conquer the mind, you conquer the world. As somebody that overthinks a lot, that really hit me and was very real, because sometimes we get in our heads about just life in general, trying to figure out what's the next step, and sometimes we just have to take it as it comes along sometimes, which is easier said than done. So that's what I like about overthinking when it comes to lyric wise. Now going to Everybody Here Wants You. So there's, let's see, what was my favorite part about here? So a lot of my favorite part of this is when they're singing together. So, and some of the ad-libs and some of the runs that they're doing pretty much in parallel. So they're running at the same time and you're just adding certain licks in to differentiate who's singing at what time. But my favorite verse probably would be, so I would have to say Kevin's first verse, which is 29 pearls in your kiss, a singing smile, coffee smell, and lilac skin, you're flaming me. 29 pearls in your kiss, a singing smile, coffee smell, and lilac skin, you're flaming me. I'm only here for this moment. So, and then how it goes in, I know everybody here wants you. I know everybody here thinks they need you. I'll be waiting right here just to show you how our love will blow it all away. So it's kind of like, you see somebody at the club, and they're garnering a lot of attention, and you see them, and you're like, what I could do, is probably, I could probably take care of you better than anybody in here that's pretty much gawking at you and taking up your time and your space. And then when it comes to Kanjale's verse, when she says, "I know the tears we cried have dried on yesterday. The sea of fools has parted from us." Wait. Hold on a second. "I know the fears we cried have dried on yesterday. The sea of fools has parted for us. There's nothing in our way, my love." The reason why I like that is kind of an answer to what Kevin is saying when he says, "I know everybody here wants you." So I like that kind of call and response between the lyrics between Kanjale and Kevin for this song. Now getting into Pray. Let me see. Again, actually no, let me go to Salvation. 'Cause Pray for me pretty much is self-explanatory. But I really like about Salvation. I think we've all been in this place. So out of all I did wrong, you always see the best in me, and it keeps me holding on to something that's better than me. You bring me out of the dark 'cause you are my salvation. You lift me out of the dark 'cause you are my salvation. And then it goes to that, it's probably one of my favorite instrumental breaks of the project. And again, it's self-explanatory, but we all have gone through some things. We might have made the wrong decisions, and we might look back and be like, "I could have did this better." But I'm not sure if you guys are religious, but if you are or are not, we all have some reflection time. So we think on our stuff, and we understand that we got through it. Either if you believe in higher power, or you do not. So again, these are my favorite lyrics. I thank you guys for paying attention to this. I really hope you guys support Kevin and this with his project. He is independent now. So everything he's doing is pretty much out of his own pocket. So I really want people to start making sure that they support R&B, especially the independent R&B artists, because they need as much support as everybody else deserves, and especially if the project is a good cohesive project, it needs to be promoted. So that's what I'm doing on my side over here on here. So again, thank you. I really appreciate you guys coming to hear what I had to say about this project. If you liked what I had to say and you guys are interested, make sure you guys go into Spotify, Apple Music, and all other streaming platforms, and look for Kevin Ross Audacity Volume 2 and support him that way. And just show him support on Twitter and his social media. And share this with all your friends. Hit the like button and subscribe button, and I'll see you guys in the next video.